Good evening, race fans. Welcome back to another week of Historic Trans Am series. We are at Watkins Glen this evening as the pace parade lap is about halfway underway. They're just in the boot right now. So we'll head on over to the starting grid while they do that. Not a big turnout tonight, unfortunately. We only had 16 show up for qualifying. On pole, DAT Wagonator, followed by Yan Zan Zan, Sia, 2004, DAT Trashman, Crafty Budman, RR Flight 602, Team Reedy, Schlepperock, Springa, 4KM T-Bird, Fight for Her, Diablo, Optimizer, Demon Child, Sia, XR8, Rob Loves Cars 1, and Gorilla Panic. Round out the 16. As we come around onto the start finish line, and away we go to start our first lap. And while I'm thinking about it, I'm going to hit go on that app so we can figure out what lap we're on. Haha, I remembered this week. We seem to get through turn one okay. No big dramas there. As we end up through Thunder Alley there into turn four. One thing about this track, of course, is the lack of runoff areas. Usually ends up getting a few people out, as Yan Zan Zan has to take it a little wide to avoid Wagonator going in through the bus stop chicane. As Sia has dropped back by the looks of it, as Trashman is currently running third. Gotta make sure I'm looking at the right screen again. Haha. Everything looks to be in order though. Good stuff. As we come up, climb out of the toe, or the heel of the boot, and heading up into turn eight. So yeah, sorry, that was the toe. We're heading into the heel now. Turn eight. When we get a small break in the action here, I have a new graphic that'll flash up. But we'll stick with this for right now. I was hoping to have a little bit more time before the race started so I could flash that up. But things were actually on time this week. As we head into turn one to complete the first lap. As we head down into turn one now to start the first lap. I got confused what corner we were in there. We will wander back to fifth with Crafty Budman and his Camaro. As you get a glimpse of the flailing arm guy in the background there. I don't know why they felt the need to add that, but hey, whatever. Not like we could have used better camera angles or something. And rant. Well, stop the rant now. As we head back into the bus stop chicane again, it's actually called the Inner Loop. Oh, as Sia is a little sideways and losing yet more positions. Very unfortunate, he's caught on the outside there. He is giving it back to... He's got the inside line, and he might be able to hold that position on Budman. Budman is going to have the inside going into the toe, turn 7 though. And Sia is forced to drop back to 5th. So he has lost two spots. Not as bad as it could have been. But he is fighting going back into the heel, turn 8. As he's got the inside or the outside going through that corner. And is he able to make it stick going back into the onto the main part of the track? Nice little give and take there. Good stuff, guys. Of course, the drink for tonight, going with a little Black Russian. Cheers. Thought he'd mix it up a little bit. Bet you weren't expecting that. Looks like Sia is able to hold on to that position and is putting a little bit of a gap between him and Budman. So what we will do is go back to 8th with Springa, who is having one heck of a battle with Fort Cam T-Bird by the looks of it, for 8th, as they go side by side down into the bus stop. Fort Cam has to concede that spot. Oh, as Springa lights him up and loses traction and also loses the position, but he is on the out. Oh, he has fallen in behind Fort Cam T-Bird, so he is giving that position up. Head on up to 3rd with Yansan San. He has lost a position to Trashman after starting 2nd. As they wind their way back up to turn 9 and back on to the, I think it's the NASCAR part of the circuit. Through turn 10 in, there's none of those stupid flailing arm things. We're gonna pop back on to 9th with Fight for Her Diablo, that success ballast horsepower cap is really hurt him, as he only qualified at 11th, but he's managed to pick up 2 spots. He has now passed Springa, and somebody else has fallen back. Looks like Sierra has moved up as well. Looks like something may have happened, some contact or something in the back. Is that Sierra behind him? I see Team Reedy. That's who I see. Is Gorilla Panic. There's Gorilla Panic. He does indeed have some damage, so there's probably some bump in there. He started 15th, so he's gained himself a few spots. Sierra looks like he has lost a spot or two. Demon Child has also lost a few spots. We'll pop back up to the battle for 5th again, see how that is shaping up with Crafty Budman. He's still not too far behind. He's certainly not letting Sia walk away from him. On lap 4, I believe, if my math is correct. As they head on in through turn 1 again. Flight, looked like Schleprock. Took turn 1 a little wide there. That's a bit of a no-no. I don't think he gained anything on it, but they were warned before the race that gaining time through turn 1, purposely taking it wide, would result in penalties. We'll pop on back to Schleprock. That beautiful 82 Firebird. You like that graphic? I hadn't made a choice when I made this, and I still haven't updated. Obviously, he picked a Pontiac. Note to self. Update the graphics. He's got some front end damage, so it looked like there was a little rub, tug. Back up to second with the trash man, who looks like he has closed on his teammate Wagonator for that battle for first. Bumper to bumper. Oh, and definitely bumper to bumper as he runs into the back of him going down the straight. This is a good little battle. We'll stick with that for the moment and actually give you more of a screen there, not occupied by my silly old drinky drink. Speaking of which, cheers. Stays off his bumper on the back straight. Better line coming out of the inner loop though, the bus stop. Yan San San has managed to capitalize on this close running and has pulled them back in as they head on down into the chute, turn six. Very good line by Yansen. Oh, see, it has gone wide. Let's see if that... he has lost the position to Budman. Budman has regained fourth. But we'll stick with this little battle here. Be interesting to see if Sia is able to pull back that position again, because he seems to have the top speed coming... well, down any of the straight bits. As random cone goes flying across track. I don't know what the barbecue went in the stands there, but something's a cooking. And again, I don't understand why they feel a need to animate stuff like that, but. And the helicopter up in the corner. Do you think if I actually went to that helicopter view that, you know, that's the view you get? No. You get some weird random one. Anyway. We're just going to go with a... Oops, sorry. A nose cam here. As they bust on up onto the back straight. Wagonator definitely got the better entry into the bus stop there and is holding the tighter line going into the carousel, the outer loop. You can see how he just pulled away just a little bit there. Oh, and he has... Wagonator goes a little deep into the toe, turn 7. But Trashman was not able to capitalize on it. We're going to go back to the replay cameras here. And Sia was able to get past... Sia was able to get past Budman again. Brain momentarily shut off. As they complete lap 6 by my account, the 17 lap race, probably start seeing them pit in the next couple of laps. Be interesting to see how pit strategies play out on this track. Looks like Yan Zan Zan has lost a little bit of ground on the front runners. Looks like they're more working together than bumping each other, which is allowing them to pull away from Yan Zan. I hate to do this, but as Wagonator tries for the pass, but thinks better about it and slots back in behind. Or Trashman, sorry. And then goes a little wide into the toe of the... Good battle, but we're going to just pop back, see what's going on back in 8th at the moment with Fight for Her Diablo. He's got Springa right behind him, and he is gaining ground on 4 Cam T-Bird by the look of it. So it's not going to be all for naught for Diablo. He's gained 3 positions so far. Looks like he's running a clean race as well. Pedal down, focus forward, and look at those tires scattered everywhere as one goes rolling down the middle of the road. Again, good thing they don't actually do damage to the cars, because that would just be a shame. Further back, we have a newcomer to the series. Rob Loves Cars 1, and he is running the 66 Nova. Good for him. Like to see the little diversity. He's currently running 15th. It's a very nice paint job he has as well. I like it. Classic look. Looks great. Why can't we get those boom cameras? Really? Come on. Turn 10, you friggin' modeled them. Put them in. A Hoptimizer currently running 16th according to this. Let's pop back and see Hoptimizer. Does he have damage or is he just having a rough go of it? Hard to tell. Well, he's got rear end damage because he's only got one light on the go. He did qualify 12th, so I'm not sure if he's having troubles with the track or if it is actual damage. Ooh, and Yan San San getting a little squirrely there. It's showing him in 6th, so I'm not sure if this is after a pit stop or if he had issues. I'm going to guess that it was pit stop. Because I do not see any damage on his car. So we'll chalk that one up to a pit stop. Ooh, as I have a little bit of stutter lag there. Zia must have followed him in as well, because it's showing him in 7th now. So we'll say that these are pit stops. Currently showing Crafty Budman in 1st, so he has obviously not pitted yet. We'll pop up and see Crafty Budman. Ooh, and he very liberal with that corner. Showing that we're on lap 9 according to my math. So that is definitely right in pit stop area territory. Trashman and Wagon... well, Wagonator and Trashman still battling for position here. Looks like they went into the pits as well and came out in the exact same order that they went in. I don't think we've seen Flight tonight so far, and he is having a battle with Schleprock for 7th. One of the couple of javelins. Oh, and that is Rob Love's Cars 1 on the side of the track. Looks like he could have retired from the race. That is highly unfortunate. Hopefully he did not run out of gas, because that would be embarrassing. Heavy damage on the side of Flight's car there. That's, again, unfortunate. Ooh, Schleprock brings her awfully close to that wall. The outside wall as they complete another lap, and this is lap 10, folks. Or starting lap 11. Let's hop on back to Gorilla Panic, who is currently in his second race with us, as he is running 15th. And again, heavy damage. It's still showing Rob Loves Cars in the list. Bathroom break? Not sure. He probably had something going on. We'll let that one go. We'll give him too much of a hard time. As it looks like everybody has now pitted, and we are back to Wagonator and Trashman and Yansansan running 1, 2, and 3, and they have Yansansan has closed the gap again. We'll stay with this battle. This is definitely the battle to be with at the moment. Ah, but before I forget, I do need, because I spent a good part of the day building this, and it's, again, it's just a work in progress. It's an idea I had, but since I put all the time into it, I want to at least display it, and I will polish it up eventually, but for now, here is the series track map. Ta-da! Again, it's something I'm working on. What was supposed to happen was I was supposed to talk about that while they were doing the pace lap, but they had their shit together today, and everything was on time. Oh, a little bit of course cutting there by Trashman. Oh, as Yansansan goes on the inside, and he's going to be on the outside, unfortunately, for this next turn. Is he going to be able to hold that position? Looks like he is going to be able to cut back in on the inside of Trashman and take advantage of that. Slight off track by Trashman and pop himself up into second, as Trashman is looking to fight back. but Yansan San closes the door on the inside there, leaving them no room to pass. Good heads up driving. Currently on lap 13. Just about to finish it actually as we head into turn 10. Tires everywhere, and into turn 11. Those two little tires wobbling down the side of the track. That helicopter hasn't moved position since we started. I call shenanigans. Pop on back to Schlepprock, who has a little bit of gap on Forcam T-Bird at the moment. Kind of running by himself a bit. Forcam's there, but he's got about a half second back. Fight for her, Diablo is currently running 8th. Not sure on the gap between him and Forcam. I haven't been able to get a view of where they are on track together. Forza, if you're paying attention, a little track map too. Just options that we can click on and off. Track map, current lap, speed or something. There we go. So he's a couple seconds back, probably about 4 seconds back, 5 maybe. Not again, because I have no idea how fast they're running, because I can't see lap times or anything like that. No idea if he's catching or not, or if Team Reedy's actually catching him, speaking of which, I don't think we've taken a look at Team Reedy all night. We'll pop on back to Team Reedy, who is currently battling with Springa and Flight 602 for 10th. This is for 10th position as they come back around turn 9 and head into turn 10. And that smoke is still going. Somebody better check that. Awfully close to that wall. Whoa. I think I've said it before. I do like that paint job that Spring has got there. Very classic. I mean, I like them all. I've got nothing against any of them that are currently on track. There was one previously that I won't bring up again, but everybody that's out there tonight, hats off to all of you, because you got wonderful, wonderful paint jobs. Very, you know, in tune with what the series was all about. Oh, just Springa goes a little squirrely coming back out of the bus stop, and that is given. Whoa, Flight into the rear quarter panel of him. That poor car of Springa's looks like it's been through a wrecking yard and back. I just noticed he's rocking the Canadian flag. Good stuff. Hey, fellow Canadian. Looks like Flight's setting up for a pass, but Springa is giving him no room going into the corner. Just about. Thanks, Dad. like the thanks, Dad, you got on the side of your car, too. As We are just about to start the 15th lap. A little bit of gap between those two, so I'm going to pop back up front again. Wagonator is still up front. Yan San San is still in second. And Trashman is still in third. Looks like there's a pretty good gap between the three of them at this moment, so we'll pop back to that battle with Springa and Flight. And Sierra's not too far behind them either. Looks like Flight has a half-decent run, but I don't think he's going to be able to catch him going into turn 8. Not enough room there, not enough straight. I honestly don't know which has the better top end, the Camaro. I think the Camaro has better top end than the AMX, depending on the setup and build, of course. And I could totally be wrong, but if memory serves me correct. And one of those random tires goes bouncing away again. Oh, as Springa nails the outside wall in turn 11. That is giving Flight an opportunity to get up on the inside going into turn 1 as they bump. Forces Flight to cut the corner a little bit. Oh, that is heavy contact. And they're able to hold on to it. That's some rough racing. And that has given Sierra the opportunity to catch right up to Flight now. As they head into the big curve. Outer loop. Down into the chute. Have another drink, Marty. Don't mind if I do. I mean, Elvis. If you like my new backdrop, this is my daughter's little play fort. I figured it was better than the crappy carpet and walls. Gives you something to look at, you know, because there's nothing going on track right now, right? I feel like I need to go back up front and see what's going on. Oh, I can't. Things are so close here. I don't think I can leave. We'll stick with it for a little bit longer. But we're on lap 16 now. Oh, as Flight gets sideways. Is that going to give room for Sierra to take advantage of that? Doesn't look like it does. Flight is covering off the inside hard. There is no way he's getting the inside of that corner. Sierra goes wide, isn't able to gain any. Oh, and there's bumping going up ahead with Fight for Her Diablo as well. They're giving her all on this last lap. Forcam T-Bird currently in Forcam T-Bird into the wall. That is unfortunate, and is this the race over and this is just a driver tire? I don't know. I don't think the race is over. We'll head on up front. The race is over, isn't it? I don't know. According to this, they should be on the last lap, but no, the race is over. I'm pretty sure it is, unless Wagonator just totally shit the bed there. Which I hope isn't the case. I feel bad. Race is over. Unless he's having some major mechanical difficulties. Yeah, there we go. There is your race, folks. I'm going to have to work on my math, apparently. Although that did show me as 17 laps. I missed one somewhere, possibly. I don't know. So, your finishing order was Wagonator, followed by Jansen Sins and DAT Trashman, Sia 2004, Crafty Budman in 5th, Schleprock, 4 Cam T-Bird, Fight for Her Diablo, Team Reedy 48, Springa in 10th, RR Flight 11th, CRXR 8 12th, Demon Child 13th, Optimizer 14th, Gorilla Panic 15th, and Rob Loves Cars 1 in 16th. So, by the looks of it, Springa was able to hold on over Flight. Flight was able to hold on over Sierra during that little last lap, rubbing and bumping. Now, again, that could have been driver tires as well. So hard to tell. Turn 10, fix that, please. It would be lovely to see what lap they're on, Sorry. Next week, we are going to be at, I think I'd have that ready already. God, I'm such a noob. There we go. Next week, we are heading to Mazda Laguna Seca, the West Coast, for 21 laps. So we will see you then. As always, I will leave you with an ad for our friends at GTR Live. Check them out. Their Twitch address is at the end of their video, so check them on out. Have a great week, and see you next time. Oh,